Unveiling the Layers, Gender in English Nouns and Pronouns. Hello, language learners. Welcome back to our English language learning series. Today, we'll be exploring an important aspect of grammar, the gender of nouns and pronouns. It's a simple yet essential concept that will help you to communicate effectively and accurately in English. So, let's jump right into it. In grammar, gender refers to the classification of nouns and pronouns. Traditional grammar recognizes three genders: masculine, feminine, and neuter. Masculine nouns and pronouns usually represent male beings or characters. For example, he, man, boy, and uncle. Feminine nouns and pronouns represent female beings or characters, such as she, woman, girl, and aunt. Neuter nouns and pronouns represent things without a gender or where the gender is irrelevant, like it, table, car, or book. Remember, English isn't as gender-dependent as some other languages, but it still plays a vital role in conversation and writing. Understanding gender in English nouns and pronouns is crucial because it impacts the accuracy and clarity of your communication. Here's why. 1. Specificity. Using the correct gendered noun or pronoun allows you to be specific in your communication. It tells your listener or reader whether you're referring to a male, a female, or a non-living entity. 2. Respect and correctness. Proper use of gender-specific terms respects individual preferences and identities. It's crucial for using titles correctly, like Mr. for men and Ms. for women. 3. Grammar rules. Correct use of gender is required to follow the grammatical rules of English, particularly in pronoun antecedent agreement. 4. Cultural sensitivity. Certain English-speaking cultures pay a lot of attention to gender identities. Misusing gendered terms may lead to misunderstanding or offense. Though English isn't heavily gendered, there can be challenges, especially for learners from languages where objects have genders. Remember, in English, most objects are neutral. We refer to a book, table, or car as it, not he, or she. Be aware of the exceptions. Some words like ship or country may be referred to as she in some contexts, especially in literature or traditional usage. A great tip for understanding and using gender correctly in English is to read widely and notice how gender is used in different contexts. That's it for today's lesson on the gender of nouns and pronouns in English. I hope this video has helped you understand why gender is important in English and how you can use it accurately in your conversations and writings. As always, keep practicing, stay curious, and happy learning.